On Hot Copy, the name Kitchie Nadal has been a byword in the country's rock scene. Now, amid her successful music venture, Kitchie is breaking into a new ground. Here's a look.
Known for her haunting vocals and music, Kitchie Nadal is dubbed OPM's rock sweetheart. And these days, she's exploring new ways of rocking the industry. Formerly the lead vocalist for the alternative rock band Mojo Fly, she gained popularity after releasing a self-titled solo album featuring her chart-topping single, Huwag na Huwag Mong Sasabihin. Hailed as one of the most successful albums released by a female artist of all time, it catapulted her from a successful recording career to numerous endorsement deals and soon a debut on the silver screen. The multi-awarded singer-songwriter has come out with her most personal work yet, a new album titled Malaya, some of whose songs are featured in the indie film The Muses. She makes her acting debut in the film, which is one of the 8 finalists in the first ever Cine Filipino Film Festival later this month. Kitchie says her involvement in filmmaking does not mean she's abandoned the music scene. She says it's all about pushing her artistic and creative limits.
Now joining us in the studio, OPM's rock sweetheart, multi-awarded singer and songwriter, Anna Katrina Dumilon Nadal, or simply Kitchie Nadal. Welcome to Hot Copy, Kitchie.
It's good to be here.
All right.
First time.
All right, good stuff. You gonna sing for us?
Yeah.
Let's do it.
This song's called Malaya.
Calling, these footsteps are falling. Tomorrow, just another world that I bow to. Name this place where I hide, you pull from inside. Motion in motion, we lose our focus with motion. You are the speed of my breathing, my memory bleeding. Certain, uncertain, are you salvation or burden? You are my silent unrest, my silence of trust. Pagbago ng tanawin, lumika ng tunog na mapapasunod. Mga ligaw ng mga bata, bigyan ng pag-asa. Di mo maiwasan sumabay sa agos ng kahirapan, pagdurusa, nalunod na sa luha. Huwag dalawang isip, humingi ng tulong. Dahil dito lamang, ako ay kaibigan mo. Mahirap ang masilayan kung ano ang hantungan. Manalig ka, maniwala ka sa aking kaharian. Malaya ka na sa aking piling.
Good stuff. All right. What a way to start a Friday morning. Welcome to Head Start. Where have you been, Kitchie?
I've been around. Actually, I've been away for almost 2 years.
Mm-hmm. And
I left 2009.
Right. Well, 2009. back with a vengeance. So back with Sandy Balyong also, yeah, accompanying you actually on percussion. Thank you so much, Sandy. Pag-usapan natin yan. Where have you been? People have been looking for you.
Ah, okay. I left 2009.
Right.
I went to Europe. Yun yung first na destination namin.
Mm-hmm.
And then Middle East, New York, US, and also Canada.
Right. What prompted this long journey of yours?
Cause I think during that time I finished an album that would be my third album.
Right.
And then I just had this parang yearning lang to just travel. Uh-huh. And we, my former manager and I, we also parang collaborated to, okay, let's do missions and music at the same time,
right,
abroad.
What do you mean by that, missions?
Missions. Usually when we get to a country, mm-hmm, the first thing na ginagawa namin, we look for a church or a ministry na, mm-hmm, who does missions, and
right,
we volunteer, mm-hmm, and then yeah, there.
Is that something you've always done? Is that
even
been
here
a very
in the
strong
Philippines
part of your life?
Yeah. Uh-huh. So parang pretty much kung ano yung mga ginagawa ko sa Philippines, parang ginagawa ko rin din siya abroad.
Okay, on a larger scale, in a different place.
Yeah, in a different place.
All right. It was certainly a roller coaster ride. I mean, from the Mojo Fly days all the way to your breakthrough album, and you know that hit song, everybody was singing it. Wag na wag mo sabihin. Your decision to actually take a trip, was that a reaction to that roller coaster ride? Na parang sunod-sunod yun, tuloy-tuloy yun. There was so much going on in those days. Did you want to take a break consciously? Did you want to find...
In a way, parang break na rin din siya. Mm-hmm. And I wanted something, parang bago lang.
Change
something
of scene?
New. Yeah.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. Nagsawa ka ba?
Or... Di naman. Music naman talaga will always be part of my life.
Right.
And siguro na lang, in a different place, there's a world, uh-huh, out there, and I wanted to try it out.
Right. So what did you discover when you went out there?
A
into
lot
the big,
of things.
To the wide world.
Mm. Well, definitely, I, in a way, parang naging ano ako eh, parang mas naging extrovert.
Uh-huh.
Extroverted.
So introverted ka pa noon when you were here?
Very much.
Okay. That's hard to believe, because I mean, you were all over the place. I mean, it's hard to believe for people who get up on stage, perform, face a huge crowd of fans, of people, to say na, actually, introverted ako eh, hindi naman ako. That's sort of, parang hindi siya...
Parang ano nga eh, contradicting, but I don't know, it helps me balance.
Really? How would you describe yourself? I mean...
I like being home, I like being with my family,
mm-hmm,
and not, I don't have a very rock style, you know, rocker.
I was about to say
lifestyle.
That doesn't sound very rock star, rock sweetheart. but it's incongruous. It doesn't seem to match. How did you manage, staying true to what you like, and at the same time, you know, music is some aspects of music is a business. You have to be out there. You have to constantly be in the eye.
Yeah.
How did you reconcile that?
I don't know. It's just like for me, like I like being myself and mm-hmm, being true to what I do.
Mm-hmm.
Like even with music, even like for this album, parang in the beginning, parang this is really gonna work, especially here in the Philippines. Uh-huh. Parang we have a different.
Look at some of the clips we've got there.
Oh, yeah,
those were the days, huh?
Yeah, those were the days. Wow.
how have you changed? Since those days.
Yeah, musically.
It's not that long ago, really. Pero, you know.
Yeah, musically, malaking nagbago. Mm-hmm. Like for this album, it's a very happy album.
Yeah.
It's not very emotional anymore. Mm-hmm. And how should I say it? Parang, because before I'm very like into like what's happening in my life.
Right. Oh.
Parang medyo consumed.
Uh-huh.
But this for this album, parang ano, involving a lot of people around me, mm-hmm, what's happening with being involved with people and society.
Uh-huh. Why, what brought about that change? I know musicians, songwriters, you know, they write from the heart what's going on in their life.
Yeah, what's going on.
What's going on in your life? What corner have you turned?
Ever since, I think because of traveling, I've learned a lot. Mm-hmm. Even like performing with Stone Force and some, it's a New York-based band.
Right.
So, I guess mas naging open-minded ako sa music. Parang, dati parang, there's, parang merong ano eh, parang ako parang may comfort zone and may formula to do music.
Okay.
But when I traveled, parang, I didn't expect that I can also perform with, you know, like an upright bass and
right,
violin, uh-huh, beatbox, mm-hmm, and what else? Yeah, at the same, all at the same time, percussions at the same time.
Well, we're talking about your music, obviously, but yeah. what happened in life, to bring about this change? Where have you been? Sino ka na ba ngayon?
I'm still the same.
Okay.
But evolved into a, well, I guess I'm more mature now.
Yeah.
And I can handle, cause before, like, I would really, parang dinunukot, pinush ko talaga yung sarili ko sa limit.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I would perform, like, even, like, 3 gigs a night. So, parang now, I learned to be more relaxed.
Okay.
And to, you know,
what like, what was driving you to to go out with a bang, to burn the candle at both ends, so to speak? Did you just have such a yearning for the stage, to perform, to share, or was it about, you know, striking while the iron was hot? Was it about getting your music out there? Or
I was just excited just and young.
Yeah,
I was very excited, mm-hmm. and I wanted to see like any potential then, mm-hmm. and that kind of like I realized that, oh wow, parang okay, that's it.
Okay. Yeah. Well, let's talk about this new bit of music that you've got, this new album.
Yeah.
Tell us about it.
Yeah, this album is, like I said, parang medyo ano siya, extroverted siya.
Uh-huh.
It involves a lot of people and places, mm-hmm. and parang social awareness.
Okay.
And
is there a theme?
Yun yung theme eh. Yun yung napansin ko eh. Parang I'm more involved with what other people's stories,
uh-huh.
and and also since this album during that time kasi I've been traveling, so medyo may influence siya ng Eastern.
Yun, that's sort of interesting. I like the percussive sound that we had here earlier also. What are some of the influences na pumasok dito?
Oh, cause I really love the instruments there in the Middle East, mm-hmm. and also more of the people talaga, mm-hmm. parang ano, and the musicians na parang how they've influenced me and kind of like gave me that ano, parang encouragement to just explore, mm-hmm. and experiment.
Mm-hmm. All right, cool. Malaya.
Yeah. Malaya.
Is that very literal? Do we take that on face value? You're free?
I'm free from
what?
free from myself. From being self-consumed.
Uh-huh. Yeah. What are some of the other... Obviously, we're going to ask you to sing a few more tracks from this album. But like, what are some of the highlight tracks from the album? Things that really stand out for you? And the process of... alin ba dyan yung pinaka
favorite
or meaningful?
Ngayon, favorite ko yung Malaya kasi
favorite ko na rin siya. It's my new favorite.
Yeah, cause it reminds me of my experience there recording in New York,
mm-hmm.
and there's a song called Isaac,
mm-hmm.
that one naman is sobrang ano, very influenced dun sa ano, sa Middle East.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay, sounds good. Well, I know that it all ties in together. You've got a lot going on.
Uh-huh.
We also want to talk about your interest, your growing interest in cinema, in acting. Pag-usapan natin yan. But for now, let's center on the music. We're going to ask you to sing us, mm-hmm. another song. We can't get enough of you. The next song is Same Ground.
Yeah.
Let's hear
something more familiar. I cried and left you out of the blue. It's hard leaving you the way when I never wanted to. Self-denial is a game of strength. Thank you.
Version actually. Now we're going to be taking a quick break. We'll continue our conversation with Kitchie Nadal when Hot Copy returns. Welcome back to Hot Copy. With us is OPM's rock sweetheart, multi-awarded singer and songwriter Kitchie Nadal. And I'm looking forward to this because everybody knows this song. Everybody loves this song. We're going to go straight into it and ask you to sing one of your most popular hits. Kitchie?
Bang sabi pati mapakali hindi makatingin sana'y huwag mo na tong palipasin at subukan lutasin sa mga sinabi mong na iba na dapat sa akala na ako'y isang bituin na walang sasambahin. Di ko man ito ipakita, abot langit ang daing sa mga'y sinabi mong na iba na dapat sa akin. Natunay kong
I'm not afraid to die.
Oh, yes! Kompleto na araw ko, Kitchie. All right, you've made my week. That was such a great rendition of that song. Everybody loves that song. Ano ba talaga yung kwento ng song na yan? What inspired this song? Did you do all the writing on this?
Yeah, I did all the writing. Actually, this is one of the songs na matagal kong tinago pero hindi ko naman inisip na magiging hit.
Aha.
Tapos
And there it was.
Tinapos ko lang siya and then I just remembered that song na parang tinago ko before and then I finished it and then I included it in the album.
So it wasn't like this is one of your biggest hits and parang people want to attach a story to this.
Yeah.
Ano ba talaga yung kwento niyan? What inspired it? Did you write it for
it's
anyone in particular?
Breakup song.
Yeah. What was going through your mind at the time?
Oh, it's actually about, you know, letting go and saying at the same time that because I care for you, because I love mm-hmm. you, then I have to let you go.
Mm-hmm. So aga naman to be talking about this. No, well, but my question is: does the meaning change over time? When you write something, syempre, feel na feel mo yan at the time, but you really pour your heart, your soul, your bones into a piece of music. Does it still hold the same weight now after many mm-hmm. years has passed? After, like you said, you've matured, after you've understood the way life works a little more. Ganun pa rin ba? Does it still mean the same thing?
Yeah, well, of course, like every season, sometimes it reminds me of this story and mm-hmm. then this story and whatever I'm going through. And now I think it's more of, you know, like the realizing, like in being in a relationship, there's like freedom to love that person. And because we have this thinking na parang if you're in a commitment, para siyang prison.
Mm-hmm.
But it's not supposed to be that way.
Right.
So parang being in a commitment is actually very freeing.
Right. How old were you when you wrote this song?
About 23.
Naisip mo na yon when you were 23?
Yung ano na yon, yung version na yon, medyo ngayon na lang.
Okay. Well, it sounds particularly mature already for somebody to really come up with that thought.
Yeah.
We've been talking about your journey where you are now. I want to take a step back and go back to the early days.
Yeah.
Did you always want to be a musician? How did you get started?
My mom's a classical pianist,
mm-hmm.
and she would always ask me to sing for her
mm-hmm.
every time she practices. But never really, I didn't really see myself at that time, doing this for as a career.
Right.
In fact, I remember I wanted to be a doctor. Parang ganyan eh.
Okay.
And then, siguro nung...
Doctor Nadal. Well, Doctor Nadal. Right.
My sister's actually a doctor.
All right.
She turned out to be a doctor instead of a singer. She wanted to be a singer, I think. But medyo nag-switch.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So, for me, I didn't really... Parang it landed on my lap eh.
Okay. How did you I don't know, make that final big leap in what was the corner that you took?
I was in college and I was really bored.
Uh-huh.
And I had Barbie and I, during the time she had a band already.
Malbis. Oh,
yeah, Barbie and Malbis. We had this common friend
mm-hmm.
na yun nga na parang wanted to audition yun nga for a singer.
Right.
And then I auditioned for their band. And yun yung first band ko, Mojo.
All right. And then from there, everything went from there.
Yeah, from well, we, during that time we were parang medyo underground din. Eh.
Right, right.
And then eventually, I left that band, mm-hmm. and then I started going solo.
All right, we've got a lot to talk about. You've also got this new acting thing, but we've got a question here from Twitter. Georgia Porgia asks, "How fast can you compose a song?" Game start now.
Ngayon na.
Ngayon na.
Okay, the fastest one I think would be that campaign song I wrote for senator.
Okay, how long did that take?
That congressman, sorry.
How long did that take?
Two hours?
Okay, yeah. So mabilis na ang 2 hours.
Oh, mabilis na ang 2 hours.
What's a long process?
Sometimes it takes a whole season to finish a song.
Yeah, so you sort of start put it aside for a while.
I don't know how to finish this particular part.
So put it. Yeah. Do you often jump from one piece of material to another and sort of juggle? Ganun ba yun?
Yeah, because ayoko rin yung parang na yun nga, like I said, I don't like that feeling of like I have to, you know, like finish it just because.
Right.
But I want to enjoy the process.
Okay. All right. Well, let's quickly talk about what you're into now. It's interesting. After many years of doing music, you're trying your hand at in cinema, in acting.
Yeah.
Yeah. Tell us about that.
Medyo accident yun eh. Okay. I met my co-writer.
Uh huh.
In New York,
mm-hmm.
when I had the gig there,
right?
And her name's Janice Perez, and she's based there.
Mm-hmm.
And then we thought of writing together this this film, mm-hmm. and then nakapasok siya sa.
Did you always want to? Did you always want to do music? Acting.
Not at all.
Right?
I never had plans before.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, I had offers.
Okay.
But I would always say no. Parang. And then,
why? Why?
I think it. What opened my mind was when I was watching this film, maraming films na from musicians, mm-hmm. like yung The Who,
right.
Bjork,
right.
Once, that movie, mm-hmm. and there, parang na-realize ko, parang this is a good way to, you know, to sell your album.
Right, but do you see it as something, do you see it as something separate? Do you see it as something that enhances the music, parallel development? I mean, do you see yourself as an artist wearing different hats, or do you see yourself as, oh, this is the Kitchie that sings and this is the Kitchie that acts, or, you know, does that all blend together for you?
Well, for this film, it's not so hard because mm-hmm. this film, it's about two musicians.
Right.
And in my role, then parang it's not very far from who I am now.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So, I guess it's, yeah, parang same lang. Medyo similar, very similar din.
Okay.
Although the discipline is different because you have to act. And usually, like, when I perform on stage, parang mm-hmm. I'm just myself and, you know, like, being goofy sometimes.
All right. Good stuff. Well, people are looking forward to this. We want to see a whole new side of Kitchie.
Yeah.
Parang it's a different Kitchie that we've never seen before. Okay, you guys, you're obviously busy. You're gonna have a few shows. Go ahead and tell us all about where you're gonna be gigging and that sort of thing.
Okay, I have an upcoming US tour.
Mm-hmm.
US in Canada, pala.
All right.
And yung mga gigs ko, you can check it in our Facebook,
mm-hmm.
Kitchie Nadal, and sometimes Twitter din.
All right, so all the details are
yeah, it's all there.
Online. Is it a lengthy tour, mahaba ba yan? There's going to be a lot of opportunities to catch you.
Yeah, it starts on July, mid-July till mid-August.
All right. Okay, and the film, of course, is going to come out
where? The film will be launched in September.
Mm-hmm. The title is Muses.
The Muses.
You know, directed by.
And my co-starring is her name's Janelle Jamer.
There you go. It's actually going to be showing at the Cine Filipino Film Festival, June 26th to July 2, at the Eastwood Resorts World Cinemas. Okay, this looks like it's going to be really, really interesting.
There you go.
Ito, ang gandang kwento neto. All right, good stuff. Well, you know, people want to hear more music from you. So really, I mean, there's. Nothing more to ask than, or nothing more that we'd like than to hear a little bit more music. One last parting track.
Yeah.
It's been a real pleasure, really, to see you guys, or to hang out with you guys and chat with you guys. So thank you so much for making my Friday morning and everybody else's Friday morning.
Oh, thank you. It's our privilege.
All right. Okay, well, that's Head Start today. I'm Paolo Abrera, Karen Davila. We'll be back on Monday. Thank you for watching. And to end our show, here's Kitchie's song, Bulong. Thanks, guys.
Ikaw ba'y nalulungkot? Nababalot pa ng puot? Maraming hinanakit sa mundo. Di alam anong gagawin, kundi ubusin ang oras sa jeep. Akala mo'y ay mararating. lahat kahit baba mo. Minsan ang kagitingan ay wala sa bigat ng pinapasan sa puso ko at pagharaam ng kabiguan. Bumangon